Aluminium fluoride is a chemical vital for various industries, including the production of aluminium. In making pure aluminium, it is a crucial flux material and reduces the energy required. Processing these chemicals requires huge amounts of energy and fresh water. The exhaust stream from the process still contains large amounts of these resources. Aluminium fluoride producer Alufluor in Helsingborg, Sweden, wants to reuse these resources instead of sending them up the chimney stack. But the exhaust is corrosive, and recycling the energy, water, and material involved is a real challenge. A new system developed within the EU-funded project iWAYs now overcomes this challenge, creating value from the exhaust streams of chemical production and other industries. Alufluor is testing one of these systems. Professor Husam Juhara from Brunel University of London is the inventor.
Condensing economizer has been developed with factories with no chimneys in mind. It is recovering the heat that has been otherwise wasted. It's condensing the water and the acids or whatever inside that stream in the liquid form. So what we are left with is really CO2, oxygen, nitrogen, and maybe some other gases. With the heat pipe condensing economizer, you are actually controlling the capture of all these contaminants in the liquid form. So it gives the industry much more control on the emission side. And I believe the chemical industry in particular will find very good use of the condensing economizer, because it will add, in addition to the energy efficiency, water recycling, materials recovery.
But how exactly does the technology work? The heat pipe condensing economizer, HPCE for short, is based on heat pipes, which are sealed and filled with a working fluid. This transfers heat quickly and passively from the hot bottom section to the cooler top part. In an HPCE, many of such heat pipes are assembled in a specific pattern. A hot exhaust stream passes through, transferring its heat to the upper part, where cool water absorbs the heat. During this process, condensate containing fluoride forms and runs down the pipes. The condensate is collected with other wastewater from the HPCE system and sent to a water treatment plant. The treated water can then be reused. After this process, the exhaust is purified and cooled further in the condensing economizer before it finally leaves the facility through the stack. The water that absorbed heat from the exhaust can reach up to 70 degrees Celsius. This is used to clean equipment, like the reactor, for example.
We looked at very cost-effective design for it and demonstrated that for such harsh environment, we can actually do a modular, flexible design for the condensing economizer.
The researchers expect the HPCE to drastically cut Alufluor's water and energy usage, achieving a substantial reduction in its annual energy consumption. Dan Torreson is the technical director at Alufluor.
We strive all the time to reduce the energy consumption, the material consumptions, and reduce the emissions, even if we are well below the permit we have. We continue to strive lower and lower. We think that iWAYs will help us a lot with this.
Integrating the new technology into the existing infrastructure required careful planning and coordination. But once operational, the benefits were evident almost immediately.
We have been running it for a couple of months now, and it has worked very well. So we have got the transformation of the energy from the gas to the water, and we have also seen reduction of the emissions.
This chemical production site in Sweden is only one of three case studies testing the new technology. A second HPCE was installed in a ceramic production site in Italy, and a third one in a steel production site in Spain.
You can apply the same thing to any other industry, but you can see where the chemical industry in particular, because they are heavily regulated, they will benefit the most, I believe.